Kentucky Kingdom since 2017.
Obviously, I started off with Storm Chaser. Did two rides, once in the front, once in the back. For me, this is easily a front row ride. The airtime was so much stronger up there.
And the only element that were better in the back
were the first drop and the first Camelback. Everything else hit much better in the front. So I'm gonna ride in the front more often than the back on this one for today.
Okay, why did the front actually look like they got more airtime?
Yes, it literally does on every single thing. Like, that was like,
no, that one.
Oh, which one is it? The like one.
That lateral.
Storm Chaser in the front row twice more, and that thing for me is better than Twisted Timbers, but I would not put it ahead of Wildcat's Revenge. Since I was last here in 2017, there are some new credits I need to get here. One of them being Kentucky Flyer, which is right over there. I am a little bit nervous about this one because my experience with Gravity Group Timberliner trains have not been the greatest. Switchback at ZZT's Amusement Park, which I rode in 2019, was a lot rougher than it should have been, and then Mindblower at Fun Spot Kissimmee, which I rode in 2021, was just god-awful. So I'm a little nervous about how Kentucky Flyer will ride, but I'm intrigued to see how it is, so let's head over there right now and ride it.
Kentucky Kingdom is a smoke-free facility.
For your ride. What's your favorite part? You never heard that. I always hear Cedar Point. Cedar Point. My favorite part of the song.
Kentucky Flyer for the first time, and I gotta say, I'm not too impressed with this one. Granted, it is still fairly early in the day, so I'm pretty sure it's running slow, but I rode the front row first and then the back row, and I didn't really get anything out of it. The front row was especially disappointing as I got pretty much no airtime, and then I did the back, which was better, but still not that good. Ryan said the first hill on it is insane. I didn't think it was that good, and honestly, yeah.
Absolutely destroyed by it.
No. And honestly, even though it was a lot rougher, I thought Switchback was a lot better. I didn't think I would think that because Switchback was rough, but here we are, I guess. Now I'm gonna go try a lightning run, which I'm super excited to get back on that as well, because in 2017, I got stapled on it both times I rode it, and it was not good. So I'm intrigued to see how it runs now, so let's head over there. But that had a pretty long line because they're only running one train, and that's at the front of the park. And since it's fairly early in the day, I imagine a lot of people are going the first. Instead, we just did Thunder Run, front row. Oh my, that was awesome. So much airtime on that thing, I was not expecting. Ryan, what'd you think?
I don't remember liking it that much.
Yeah, that was really good.
I think that's better in Timberwolf.
Oh yeah, I definitely agree. The closest thing I would compare this thing to would be like Hurler and Timberwolf, which actually I somewhat enjoyed Hurler. Yeah, I agree with that. Even though I didn't enjoy Hurler for what it was, this thing kills that thing. And even Timberwolf, which I thought I would like Timberwolf better. This thing is awesome. Since we just tried the front, we're gonna try the second of back row, see how that is.
Yay!
Just got the final new credit I needed here, which is Roller Skater. I could rent this in 2017, but I don't think I even saw it, so I didn't even get on it. And it was just a standard kid coaster, nothing really special here. Although the turn back into the station had a surprisingly good amount of laterals, and I slid across the road, so that was pretty funny. Now I'm gonna go try and get on Lightning Run again, see if that line died down from earlier. ice structures now, and I got Storm Chaser over there, Kentucky Flyer over here, and let me tell you, Kentucky Flyer looks awesome from here. And I saw a train stop on Littleville for about, I don't know, 25 or so seconds, and then kept going, so I'm glad that it didn't break down. Actually, Storm Chaser's going way over there. Some of the track and supports from T3, the Vekoma SLC the park used to have, just sitting over in that parking lot over there. I saw a couple other pieces from inside the park, and they were over near, I think, Thunder Run somewhere, so. Storm Chaser, and I'm done riding for the day. My thighs are killing me from the airtime on this thing, which I kind of expected that it would going in, but man, this thing is just an absolute beast. Kentucky Kingdom is now over, and my final ride count was 10 on Storm Chaser, 2 on Kentucky Flyer, Thunder Run, and Lightning Run, and then 1 on Roller Skater. In terms of highlights, Storm Chaser shooting way up in my list, Thunder Run being a surprisingly good ride, Lightning Run and Kentucky Flyer were underwhelming, but that didn't take away from how good Storm Chaser and Thunder Run were. Overall, it was nice to get back to this park, having not been here since 2017, so it's been 7 years. And before we click on this video, please leave a like if you haven't done so already. Be sure to comment what you enjoyed about this video, and be sure to share with someone else if you know. If you're new to this channel, like we saw, please consider subscribing for more content like this. My goal is to hit 1,000 subscribers by the end of the year, so I'd appreciate you subscribing and turn the bell so you get notified every time I upload a new video. I also have an Instagram account for the pictures I take whenever I visit the parks, so be sure to check me out there as well. We have the link in the description. As for this next vlog, it will be from Holiday World, where I will be getting on good gravy for my first time, as well as keeping my streak of riding Thunderbird every year since it first opened alive for the 10th year in a row. So stay tuned for that. Until then, I'll see you later.